Hi guys, Jordan with Motion Array, and today we're going to be teaching you how to create your own fake film grain right inside of Premiere Pro. It's a really simple process and the results look something like this. So let's take a look. Alright, so here we are inside of Premiere, and I have a shot here that we want to make look like it was shot on film. To get right to the tutorial, go to this time code here at the bottom, but we want to just briefly clarify something. When people talk about adding film grain, there's usually two different types that they're talking about. There's the over-the-top type of film grain that makes it look like your footage was shot about 100 years ago. And then there's the more subtle film grain that comes from the photochemical process of actually shooting on analog film. We're talking about that second one. And there's a lot of packs and overlays that you can purchase to get that subtle film look. But if you don't want to spend any money, you can actually create something very close and similar right inside of Premiere Pro. The first thing that we're going to do is just add an adjustment layer so that we can work with it instead of our video clip. The reason we do this is because chances are you want this effect to be something that's stretched over multiple clips, and it's easier to do it just once rather than for each individual clip that you might be working with. So right click on your project manager and go to New Item, Adjustment Layer. Then drag and drop it over top of your footage. Next, we're going to go to our effects panel and then search for the noise effect. Or go to Video Effects, Noise and Grain, Noise. And then drag and drop this effect onto our adjustment layer. Cool, so right now, right off the bat, you should see no difference. But here's where we actually start to create the effect. Just to show you what this effect does, we're going to take this slider here labeled Amount of Noise and raise it up really high, just to get a clear picture of what's actually going on. So we can see here that we get a really ugly look, like we set the camera's ISO way too high. What we're going to do is quickly transform this bad-looking noise into really nice-looking grain substitute. So to start, go to the checkbox here beside Use Color Noise and deselect it. It might be tough to see, but this takes away any color from the noise itself, which immediately makes it more like grain and less like noise. So now let's take the amount of noise percentage down to something really low. My personal recommendation would be anywhere between 8 to 15%, depending on how harsh or subtle you want this look to be. But feel free to play around with it and see what you like best. But there's one last problem we still have to address. If you're working in a 24 frame per second timeline, this will work fine on its own. But if you're working with a 30 frame per second or 60 frame per second timeline, this effect will look broken because the noise will be moving around too rapidly. It won't look like film grain anymore, and the illusion will be broken. So if that's your situation, you'll need to work with a slightly different system. To start, you'll quickly need to create a new sequence that's set up for 24 frames per second, or 25 if you're on the PAL system. To do that, go to File, New, Sequence, and then set it up for 24 frames per second. Either 23.976 or 24 is okay. Next, we're going to be placing a solid down that we can see the noise over top of. You're going to want to create specifically a 50% gray solid. To do that, go to your Project Manager, right-click, and under New Item, select Color Matte. Set the specific color number to 7F, 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 and then hit OK. And if it helps, you can title it 50% gray to help you remember what it is. Great, so now do the same process that we previously did. Create an adjustment layer. Add the noise. Set your percentage. Get rid of the color. And now we have our effect set on top of a gray background. You may have seen this particular look on film grain pack overlays before. So next, what we're going to do is set a good amount of time for this to be running for. For me, I'll let it go for about 10 seconds. Then set your in and out points with I and O, and export your video. Either use Ctrl or Command M, or go to File, Export, Media. Now here's the catch. You're going to want to export it at the highest possible quality to make sure that each individual piece of noise or grain is as clear as possible. So let's set the profile to high, level to 5.1, render at maximum depth, VBR 2 pass, target bitrate and maximum bitrate at 150, and use maximum render quality. Then, name it and let your computer export the video to the destination of your choice. Awesome! Now that our computer has exported the film grain overlay, bring it into our project manager, and double-click it so that it appears in your source monitor. Now from here, click on the little video icon and then drag onto your timeline to drag only the video portion and exclude the audio. Place it over top of your footage, and this is what we have. Now comes the magical step. Go to Effect Controls, and under Blend Mode, choose Overlay. Now we can see that our effect has been properly included into our footage. And if it looks great, leave it as it is. But if you want to tone it down just a little bit, bring down the opacity of your film grain clip. And guys, that's literally it. You just created your own custom film grain substitute. To be clear, this isn't intended to replace film grain overlays, but I would actually encourage you to do a blind test for yourself and see if you can actually tell the difference between them. The bottom line is that it's a super simple $0 solution for getting a really desired look. But if you did want to get a slightly more professional film grain, we have a pack here over at motionarray.com. And hey, if you're watching this on YouTube, congratulations! We're giving a 20% discount off your first month subscription, so use the link in the description to sign up. But guys, that's it for me. I hope you found this video helpful, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.